Hello, dear friends, how are you? In this video, I would like us to learn a little bit about a very special prayer called the Amidah prayer, which basically it's a daily prayer that we all can say, and it's basically such a beautiful opportunity for us, the Amidah. It have 18 blessings inside and gives us all the strength and all the light that we need for the entire day. So I would like to share on the screen the Amidah connection. You can also find it on my website, lovekabbalah.com. And the prayers, you see I put it on the screen. You can all see it. I make it a little bit larger. It's called the Amidah prayer. So you can read it over there. You can read it, and there's like also translation in English for the prayer. And also what they put here for every prayer, there's actually 18 blessings, but later on they added another one, altogether 19 blessings. So each time that you're supposed to actually say a prayer, I wrote it right here. Say, Baruch Atah Adonai, Magen Avraham. That's a prayer. And then the second one, again, Baruch means before that, there's like more words you can say actually. It's like the actual prayer in Hebrew that they actually translated it to English. But the actual prayer I actually added here with the actual transliterations, how you actually can supposed to say it in Hebrew, and the reason why, I put it over there so we can actually through the prayer, through the actual original way to say it in Hebrew, you're actually drawing the light, you're actually manifesting and awakening the light force of the Creator within you, in your consciousness, and for the entire world through those actual letters that you say. So something very interesting to know about the Amidah, this special Amidah. Amidah in Hebrew means standing. You say the entire wall, the entire Amidah, the entire prayer as you stand, and you say it silently in such a way that only your ears can very quietly hear what you're saying. And the idea is that in this prayer, there's a lot of other prayers, but all the rest of the prayers basically preparing you for this prayer. Even the Shema Israel, the blessings of the morning, everything else is just a preparation for this prayer called Amidah, which is the 18 blessings prayer. And what's unique about it is it says in the Zohar in many places, but it's like a prayer that you actually stand in front of the Creator and you actually have a conversation with Him. It's only you and God, only God and you. That's why we say all those prayers, we say all those blessings, even though, but as you're gonna see when you'll read it, you'll see that we don't ask for personal things. We ask for global things. We're asking for everyone, for humanity, for the world. And so you're welcome to start to use it. You'll see. If you want to use it, you'll see that it will be such a great tool for you. I'm usually, it's like the best time to do it in the morning, but you can also do it in the afternoon. And you'll see that as you're seeing it on a daily basis, gives you a lot of strength, a lot of consciousness, a lot of certainty, a lot of faith, a lot of belief. And you actually will be able to see that you can manifest amazing things in your life. So just few ideas about the prayers, about the prayer of the Amidah. So the first three blessings are correspond to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, correspond to the three column system that we learn about it from Rabbi Ashlag in the different writings of Rabbi Ashlag, especially in the Zohar. So as we say the first blessing, right? The first blessing, which is connected to Abraham, connected to mercy, connected to right column energy. What is the thought? What is the focus and the consciousness that we're supposed to have as we say the first blessing? First blessing is to awake within us the ability to love unconditionally. That's the idea of the first blessing, which means we're connecting and we're igniting and we're strengthening within us the energy of right column, the energy of Abraham, the energy of total mercy, total kindness, unconditional love. So we're focusing and we're meditating to build it inside us on the first blessing. As we continue with the second blessing and also say the actual blessing, Baruch Ata Adonai, so what's the idea of the second blessing? The second blessing is left column, Isaac. What is the idea of Isaac and left column and you know, left column? The same way that in our body we have the right column aspect and the left column and the middle of the body. Everything in life builds with the three column system. So the left column is the idea of fear, but in a positive way. Fear that is not with the right consciousness become anxiety, and then fears start to take over the person and makes a person angry, sad, depressed, and you know, arguing. So we're not talking about that type of fear. We're talking about a positive fear. What does it mean, a positive fear? Positive fear is the fear that I don't want to hurt the other human being. That's a good fear. When we have that fear, when we are so cautious about the way that we talk, the way that we think, the way that we act, we will be so careful and we'll end up not hurting the other person. As we learn from Rabbi Ashley, the entire Torah is built, is standing on the idea of loving the fellow man and not hurting the other human being. So that's why the main two concepts that a person is supposed to have in his mind, the main two focuses, and especially in the Amidah prayer, as we said, the first blessing is to build the idea of loving and caring and seeing the good within that human being and being unconditional and truly caring for that human being. That's the right column energy. Now in the second blessing, we're building the left column energy. What is the left column energy? The ability to be careful in every moment of life, to be cautious not to hurt the other human being. That's what we're meditating as we sing the second blessing of the Amidah prayer. Now, as we, you know, as we continuing to the third blessing is now connected to Jacob, from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So Jacob is the central column energy. What is the central column energy? What are we focusing on the third blessing, which is Baruch Ata Hashem Adonai. I'm sorry, just a second. One second. Okay, so in the third blessing, we say Baruch Ata, and then we say Adonai, and then we say Ha'el Akadosh. Why? Because here we have the third blessing. What is, by the way, everything before that you can either say or just read with your eyes, and then actually say right here the transliteration here. And what's the third blessing? What's the idea of the third blessing? The third blessing, as we just said, is central column. What does it mean, central column? The same way that when you're walking, so you have the right leg and the left leg, and the right left and the left leg. Sometimes you can even run, but you're constantly moving forward in a balanced way. Why? Because you're using the right and the left, and the right and the left. According to Kabbalah, that's the secret of life. You're constantly supposed to use the right and the left. Right energy is sharing, and loving means to constantly focus in life how to share and to love unconditionally. In the same time, you have to use the left leg, the left concept, which is constantly be cautious, constantly being cautious not to hurt the other human being, constantly being cautious not to hurt the other human being. So you have both both together. And if you're using those, both of them together, you constantly will find the exact balance in life, in everything. Because the focus of God is to bestow good, is to share endlessly, endless love without any desire to receive it all, just to share. Once our goal in life is the same goal of God, once we're taking upon ourselves that our goal in life will be the same goal that God have, what is it? Just to bestow good, just to share. From one hand, to love and to share unconditionally. From the other hand, not to hurt that human being. Constantly this concept, we're becoming partners of God because we have the same goal of God. So we become unified with Him. What does it mean unified with Him? That we just become unified with Him. That we have the same mission, the same focus, and we constantly working together. God and me and God, we're walking together toward revealing the light of love in the world. So central column is to be able to build that connection of so much, you know, again, as we said, after you're building the right column energy and the left column energy, now all what's left is just to spread the light of love, the light of God in the world. That's the central column energy. And that's what we're meditating on, that we'll have the ability to do that for the entire day. Because the Amidah, the prayer that you say on the Amidah, affecting your consciousness for the entire day. Now you'll see that there's different kind of blessings. For example, the fourth blessing, request for understanding, to receive knowledge, to receive the knowledge of God. The next one, returning to God for repentance. It's the idea of repentance in a deeper way. It's actually constantly to look inside, constantly to check what I need to change, what else I can learn about myself, how can I get closer to God. It's like repentance. It's like to, you know, to look inside. Then if we're moving forward, the next request for forgiveness. One of the things that in life we don't always have the guts, the strength to actually ask for forgiveness from people or from the universe, from the creator. So we ask for forgiveness. Once you ask for forgiveness, everything is being forgiven. Just take responsibility. Just realize the mistake that you did in order to move forward and clean yourself. So, you know, God is always forgiving. We just need to open ourselves and to desire that light of forgiveness to enter. The next one, requesting divine help for personal needs. Request for freedom from affliction. One second. In this blessing, we receive the strength for the Creator to redeem us from all our darkness and our negative thoughts and our egoism, everything that's blocking us. The next one, number 8, request for healing. There's like a special opportunity for ask for ourselves and for others for healing. Healing not necessarily just when something, one of the organs of the body is not functioning well. We see, you know, sometimes, especially in our time, we see that the world is pretty sick. There's people in the world that looking at life or thinking or understanding life in a way that it's kind of, it's like you say to yourself, you know, it's like, what's wrong with those people? How did they get to such a way of understanding life? It's so far away from truth, from anything that is makes sense or logical. So to heal ourselves from all the sickness of the dark forces that make our consciousness sick. So we're moving forward to number nine, request for financial prosperity, as we already learned, to ask for all the blessings so I can share and give blessings to the world. The next one, seeking divine help for Jewish people, society, and community needs. It's also for, all the people. Not that Jewish people are the children of God from a point of view, not because they are better than anyone else, just because they are on a mission to help all the people of the world to get closer to God and to be unified with God by learning the secrets of life, the secrets of how to connect to God. That's exactly what we're talking about. So that's the idea of giving strength to the people of Israel to spread the message of God to the world. Next one, number 11, prayer seeking the establishment of the kingdom of heaven. So we're asking the Creator. One second. There's unfortunately many times judges, the judging in a way that it's they involve politics, they involve different kind of agenda in the way that they judging, and it's creating a lot of chaos in the world. We're asking the Creator to bring real judges that will judge based on true justice, justice from heaven. Okay, next one, number 12, request for protection from enemies. That's another, very important one. Remove enemies, not necessarily physical enemies, mainly spiritual enemies, those enemies that attacking our mind, attacking our consciousness, causing us to be sad and to be depressed sometimes and think negative. Those are spiritual enemies that we're receiving from the Creator, help to defeat them. Next one, 13, request for mercy upon God's people. Baruch atah mesh. It's a special prayer to receive the support from the tzaddikim. There are souls in the upper world that all what they want is just to support us and to give us strength so we can be tremendously successful in our journey. And they're ready to help. And this prayer connecting us to the prayer of the tzaddikim, they're praying for us and giving us strength. Next one. Request for the building of Jerusalem. We know, according to the Zohar, that Jerusalem is the physical place that's representing a spiritual place. Jerusalem, it's the have the word of peace inside. And the idea of Jerusalem is that Jerusalem is the place, is the city that bring love and light and peace to the world. We're praying for Israel and for specifically Jerusalem to be built and to be, and the temple will be built, and the Jerusalem will be able to function as the city to bring the message and the light and love of God to the world. Number 15, prayer for the branch of David. Baruch atah Adonai, so we know that from King David will coming the Messiah from this bloodline of King David. So we actually asking and praying for the Messiah to be revealed in the world. Messiah, it's not necessarily, it's like people looking at it from a religion point of view, religious point of view. We understand that redemption, Messiah, is basically a new era, new level of consciousness that all the people of the world will be awakened to to take upon themselves the idea of loving unconditionally, the idea of letting go of the desire to receive for the self alone, with the ego. And as a result, we're going to be revealed so much light that we just push away the darkness from the world, and we, all of us, will experience a new era. A much, much better area with so much more revelation of light, and the darkness would fade away. So that's what we're praying for. We should pray for it. We should desire it. Because what we're praying for, what we desire, that's what God gives us based on our request, based on our desire. So obviously for us and for humanity. Number 16, a request for prayer to be answered. That's a very unique one. It's like we're actually asking from God, please God, listen to our prayers. Please listen and answer our prayers. So in this prayer, after we sing it, Baruch Ata, and then we say Adonai, Shomea Tefila, which basically means, blessed are you, O Lord God, who answers prayer or who listening to prayers. So here, right here, we can pause and basically ask everything that we'd like to ask in our own language. Means you can use your own language and say to God and ask and pray and request from God anything that you'd like, basically. You know, I usually, of course, recommend to ask to receive the strength to love others. Because when you involve with sharing and caring for others, you become unified with God. You're already going to have everything. You don't need to mention to God, God, give me this, God, give me that. You'll have everything, all the pleasures of life coming when you're focusing and involved with sharing, caring for others. So, you know, the best thing to ask, and of course, you can also have a personal request, but the best thing to ask, I would say, is to ask from the Creator, give me the ability to love every human being. Give me the ability to care for every human being. Give me the ability to bestow and influence good for every human being. Give me the ability to see the good within every human being, and so on and so forth. You can continue and build your own prayer. By the way, the personal request, sometimes people are more comfortable to request the personal request in their own language toward the end of the prayer. It's also possible. I'll show you in a second. The 17th one is request to restore temple service, which basically means to that the light force of God would shine again in the place of the Holy Temple, and as a result, you know, reveal, be available for all the people of the world. So again, that's a very important prayer as well. Number 18, giving of thanks to God for his mercy, right? So this one is also another one, is basically a spiritual prayer that helps us to build appreciation, allow us to see the good through in that entire day and just deeply, deeply appreciate all the blessings that God brings us. And the last one, number 19, request for peace, very important, very beautiful prayer. We actually ask for personal peace, peace between us, peace amongst us, and peace for the entire world. And then in the end, you'll see over there how you basically finish the entire Amidah prayer. But again, as I just mentioned before, if you feel more comfortable right here, you know, right here, before you actually, you know, there is the idea that as you entering the Amidah prayer, you're taking three steps backward and three steps forward, which basically means to go out of the consciousness of taking and receiving for myself alone and injecting consciousness of sharing and actually elevating my consciousness, because I'm actually entering to stand in front of God in a private meeting. That's why, by the way, in the Amidah prayer, it's better to get dressed in a way that is a proper kind of dress, and to, you know, wash our hands, wash our face, because we're actually standing in front of God. And just before we're finishing, we're actually drinking three steps backward, because we're actually kind of leaving the palace, leaving the special room of the Creator, spiritual room, obviously, you know. So just before you leave, just before you take three steps way backward, you can have the personal request that we spoke about before. You can also say it right here. And It's such a great opportunity to say anything in your own words to the Creator. This prayer, I personally love, and it gives me a lot, give me strength. I really recommend everyone to use it. It's also can and will affect your life in a tremendous way, but you also will be able to see that with this prayer, with this, the energy of this prayer, giving you tremendous strength to help others, to open your heart, to love unconditionally, and as a result, actually to affect the entire world with your prayers, with your all this beautiful revelation of light. So that's a little bit about the Amidah prayer. Thank you so much. If you have more questions, anything about the prayer, you're always welcome to contact me. I'll be happy to help. Take care and blessings.